Right, so if you're watching this video, you've probably seen the one where we accidentally teleport from one part of London to the other. If you haven't seen it yet, you're welcome to open it in a new tab. It's in the description below and it's less than a minute long. But what I'm covering in this video is I'm going to show you how I made that video with some basic editing in Adobe Premiere Pro. Okay, so I've been editing this and I realized I forgot to mention that in order to follow this video efficiently, you might want to familiarize yourself with masking and toggling the opacity of your sequences. The most important things, or the two most important things that you want for this video, is you want the foreground with the subjects in it, but you want an exact matching background with nothing in it. You can just ignore these adjustment layers up top there for color. So this is pretty short, so I'm just going to alt and drag this over to repeat this clip a few times, so it just is as long as I want it to be for after we've teleported away. So this is basically the scene. She touches me and we teleport away. And I just need to find the exact point where I want us to start teleporting from roughly. And I found it over there. So I'm gonna divide it and alt and drag that up. So I've got two copies of this in the above two layers. And I'm just gonna drag this over ever so slightly and take this background and just put it here. So this is the original set of video clips that was used for the movie. And if you look over here, you can see that I disappear slightly before Julia did, which is why I needed to repeat these two layers above. And what I did to make myself disappear first, I masked myself only and adjusted that opacity to have me disappear. And as I disappear, you still see the background because it's in the layer below. And I did the exact same thing to Julia where I masked her separately in the other clip and then had her slowly disappear away. And as we both disappear, both those clips have gone, but the background is still there. And if you recall, our teleportation method was via smoke, and I got that off productioncrate.com, and they've got thousands of different animations that you can choose from for your videos. I recommend downloading .mov files when you can, they're just easier to work with. And it's downloaded and placed in my timeline. See, there it is. Now this required a bunch of adjustments to its positioning, to its scale, to its rotation, etc., etc. So that required a bunch of playing around with. And if we go back to this original set of clips which I used for the video, you can see that I used two smoke animations, one for myself and one for Julia, which appeared at different times and were edited to match the jumping. And very importantly, I just added some whoosh whoosh sound effects, which is it. Those are just grabbed off of YouTube, just pulled them directly through. And for our landing, I pretty much just did the opposite. We first start off with the background and have us landing. Because we jumped at the same time and landed at the same time, I didn't need to separate the landing sequences and therefore did not need to mask us out individually and reduce the opacity for each half of our jumping segments. All I needed to do was put in a transition, and that allowed us to reappear into the image. Yeah, so that's how I did the teleportation effect. There are probably more efficient ways of doing it, but it was the way that worked best for me. Let me know what you think, and thanks for watching.